Yes, the phone had been hit with a hammer, burnt alive, and drowned. Yes, it still works.
I'm sure many of you know by the thumbnail and the intro I'm going to make that this phone has been through hell, also known as my uncle's house. Now, initially, this thing had been dropped in a heater, literally letting the case set on fire and melt. Then it had been dropped in a bathtub. And then it was hit with a hammer and a screwdriver afterwards. Despite all of that, that phone still had the courage and the insanity to go through another 2 grueling years of being thrashed with Roblox, finally being dumped in the end of 2021 because the battery was swollen, unsurprisingly. Now, I got extremely lucky with that display I had laying there for that, I guess, channel banner, and also a battery I got from that dead phone. Now, this is extremely handy because you can probably tell the display still has life in it, it's God knows how, but it shuts off very frequently and the battery is completely stuffed. Now, the things I'm going to be doing in today's video is pretty simple. Replacing the battery and the screen and doing a successful data recovery on it, because Jesus Christ, that still has life in it and I know it. And the funny thing I just realized is the person who repaired this before me actually used that double-sided tape I use for repairing my devices, which means they went straight to Officeworks and got the first thing they saw. Now that I've gotten that extremely thin and fragile cable, I guess unrouted, if you can call it that, the next thing is to unfasten all those screws there, given that you got into this stage without breaking that very fragile back cover. Now I'm extremely cautious of not puncturing that massive spicy pillow. I'll link all the songs down in the description. Bruh, is this just scathing OnlyFans? Now, I'll be doing a mini review on the phone I'm now using because my Note 3 died. Or rather, Facebook killed it. And it's the S5, the ultimate phone that Samsung, you know, couldn't ever replace again. Now, I think it's all about getting the screen off. So, it's going the way I suspected, and damn, even the frame has shit baked on it from being dropped in the heater. Yes, we're inside, and that puffy boy... Jesus Christ. It really wasn't. Yeah, so now it's all about transferring all the parts across. Now, in this situation, I'm quite lucky because I have 2 displays, one with a big puffy pillow on it, but I can steal all the screws I need. And I've also noticed, ignore the alcohol, but I've also noticed a slight amount of corrosion when it was dumped in the bathtub, so how the fuck did you keep on going? Yeah, so I've got it reassembled, I guess. I'll do another video bit where it's mostly done. Alright, moment of truth. I'm gonna plug it into my battery pack. Hopefully it doesn't, you know, do another Note 7, I guess, reenactment. One amp output, just to be safe. Now, plug this puppy in. Please don't balk. Come on. Backpack, you better not stuff up. Alright, the usual shielding isn't getting immediately warm, which is a good sign, I guess. Still concerning. I'll try another cable. Jesus Christ, that scared me. I just got a bit of something out of the screen. Yep. So, this display is also fucked, but it's less fucked than that thing because, hey, it's only got a massive dead spot there and it's giving people seizures rather than Thor's hammer. So That's really fucking good news. I don't know if it was just me, but the cable was already torn. It'd been sent to fucking hell. But when I plugged it in, it it turned on. So that's something, I guess. This poor nugget, though. You're probably wondering as to why I don't have a good display for this, and that's simple. They're expensive because they're fucking good displays. And Dank Pause actually helps. Get the stick with the sticky. So also the next step will to be rerouting the cables from the other housing. Also known as like the antenna, there's a couple cables up here as well. This is for that puffy pillow. Vibration it has, all the rest it has, so I guess it's just, you know, some of those. It looks so cursed. God help. Alright, I'll get the double-sided tape and I'll be back. Alright, I'm back. Now, no, I'm not also going to seal up the phone fully, because that's very pointless. Like, just look at the fucking state of it. But then, I mean, I'm not going to double tape everything perfectly. It's just going to be, if it isn't, it isn't. Wow, my scissors are getting pretty gummed up. I'm such an idiot, I forgot to put the screws in. Do note there are different sized screws, so like, you will want to take care of that. Almost done this cacophony. Oh, this song is so ironic. Of the situation, at least. That's why I'm gonna let it play. My 2011 iMac's having a hard time. It's got another Chrome tab open and it dropped the YouTube frames to about, I could say, 2 or 3. Safely. Oh, it just completely bonked out for a second. Damn, nice macro depth sensor. Meow. Meow. And yeah, that's a blister that I rubbed off, whilst pushing a push mower on a lawn. It still hurts, a fair amount. Yeah, I think they're talking about a beep. Not beep, not good, okay? Not touch drug. This is cringy as fuck, but it's beautiful. I'll just button this bitch down. Nah, mate, this thing was not dropped in a heater, was not dropped in a pool, and it was not hit by a hammer. Why would you say that? And yep, still damn works. This has been an Essex Edge 7, or Essex Edge running 107, on Essex Edge 7, for the, fourth time? Whatever, I'll see you guys later. Thanks so much for watching.